Hello and good afternoon from Proactive New York. Joining me today is Tom Equels, CEO at AIM ImmunoTech. Tom, great to see you. How are you?
Good to see you, Christine, and thank you for having me on your show.
Of course. Tom, we're seeing more clinical data regarding your flagship drug Ampligen with checkpoint blockade therapies. What should investors be taking away from this data?
Well, it's important to understand what we've done. In late 2016, one of my first things as a CEO was to repurpose Ampligen into oncology in a big way. And we marshaled efforts in vitro and preclinical and animal studies to allow us to show a basis for clinical trials in humans using Ampligen as a single agent therapy, as well as using Ampligen in combination with checkpoint blockade drugs, so that we could get human data to establish Ampligen as a powerful agent in immuno-oncology for unmet medical needs. And cancer trials take several years to, you know, complete and develop, but I'm pleased to announce that a lot of this data has just been published over the past 60 days, much of it at the AACR convention, American Association of Cancer Research, including a paper in the AACR journal, a major abstract on Ampligen and its interim results in conjunction with Keytruda, and providing a really significant therapeutic response in that preliminary interim data. And we see the same thing in triple negative breast cancer study that was done at Roswell. So these are very powerful signals that tell us that we were on the right track when we repurposed into oncology, and Ampligen is making a difference in multiple different types of tumors, some of the worst of the worst: late stage pancreatic cancer, advanced recurrent ovarian cancer, stage 4 triple negative breast cancer. And when you're dealing with those types of tumors, you know, the people who are diagnosed with those problems are really facing a death sentence because they're out of options. So we're trying to deal with that lethal malignancy, that unmet medical need, by providing not only those subjects who suffer from these horrible malignancies, but practitioners who are treating them with a new option that might lead to success.
Could you maybe explain a bit more in layman's terms how Ampligen is having an impact with Keytruda?
Okay. As I said, there was a recent abstract published at AACR by Dr. Bob Edwards and his team at the University of Pittsburgh. Dr. Edwards is really the preeminent gynecological oncologist in the United States. And the work that he's done in combining Ampligen with Keytruda to meet this unmet medical need had very significant preliminary results. It's a Merck grant sponsored a 45 subject phase 2, which is underway right now. But in those first first 17 patients, I believe, the data was extremely compelling, suggesting that there was an important therapeutic event taking place that needed to be looked at. So they published this abstract. The abstract, you can find it on our website. But what it showed was there were approximately 15% complete responses, another 20% of partial responses, and an additional 25%+ of disease stabilization type events that would be considered of clinical benefit. So in the short term of this therapy, we were seeing very high levels of response, much higher than would ever be expected with no treatment or any other alternative treatment by itself. With Keytruda, when we added Ampligen, it was like boom, you know, and that's why they published the results during the phase 2 of the interim subjects, because I believe that the team at Pittsburgh felt that the oncology community needed to know what's going on, needed to know that the signal was so strong and compelling that people should pay attention to it.
So just quickly, what are kind of the next steps here? What should investors be looking out for?
Well, the FDA recently authorized us to commence a phase two study in the United States, and we hope to also have a European site at Erasmus Medical Center. The principal site in the U.S. will be at Buffett Cancer Center in Nebraska, but with other sites. We intend to move that as quickly as possible, and that'll be a phase two of Ampligen as a standalone therapy in advanced pancreatic cancer, locally advanced. Now, again, this is a very serious lethal malignancy. Everybody knows what happens when you have late stage pancreatic cancer. So we're doing this study based upon a 27 subject study, which we completed. The results from that were published in March in a journal called Cancers, a peer-reviewed journal. And it showed, median survival, that was very significant, 19 months, approximately almost 8 months over what was seen with the standard of care. So it made a big difference in survival for these pancreatic cancer patients who were in the very late stages of the disease. So that data was published in March, and it's also on our website where you can see it. But it tells us that there's not just a signal, but a green light to go forward with a big phase two. We're doing 90 subjects that will establish additional data in a randomized controlled trial. It's going to be managed by a CRO, Amarex, which is one of the world's most well-respected CROs. And the principal investigators in the United States are coming from Buffett Cancer Center, and in Europe from Erasmus Medical Center. And this 27 subject study, which was the foundation for us moving into this next step, was done at Erasmus Medical Center. And that was under the auspices of Professor C.H.J. Van Eyck, who is, I think, generally regarded as the world's most foremost pancreatic cancer oncologist by many. Now, the importance of this is that we see an opportunity to help people with pancreatic cancer extend their life, extend their quality of life, and possibly, because we're going to administer the Ampligen in this new trial for a longer period of time, even achieve much higher levels of survival. That's what we're striving for. We believe it has the potential to do that. But like all clinical trials, the reason you do a clinical trial is to scientifically prove that you can do that in a safe and effective manner. So that's what we're doing now. But we're moving into this next step because we're moving towards, a goal of getting Ampligen approved in these lethal solid tumors so that we can save lives, and we want to move as quickly as possible to do that. Now, this is Ampligen by itself. We also believe there's an important role for Ampligen in combination with other immunotherapies, especially checkpoint blockade therapies. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to take a moment to get a little technical about how Ampligen works, in combination with checkpoint blockade therapies. And it's much the same way it works as a standalone. Tumors are able to, especially in diseases like pancreatic cancer, for example, you'll note that, many times people don't know that they have pancreatic cancer until it's way too late. It's because these tumors are immunosilent. And the immune system doesn't detect and react to the tumor. Now, the reason for that is in the microenvironment of the tumor, the immune profile of the tumor is skewed in a way that camouflages the tumor. It's what's called a cold tumor, a tumor that is not being detected by the immune system. Now, the way it does that is with heightened levels of Treg cells, also known as suppressor T cells. So Ampligen, what the findings suggest from many of these different studies, so we're getting it from a lot of different angles, different institutions, in different tumors, Ampligen, we believe, is altering the microenvironment of the tumor so as to increase the level of killer T cells or T effector cells and reduce the level of Treg cells or suppressor T cells. Everybody knows why a killer T cell is called a killer T cell, but few know why you have this Treg cell called a suppressor T cell. It's because it suppresses, in the most general of terms, the immune response. Now, when that ratio shifts and the suppressor T cell levels drop, then the immune system identifies this tumor, sometimes for the first time, and allows the immune system to begin to attack and kill the tumor. And checkpoint blockade drugs work the same way. If the checkpoint blockade drug, because of this immunosilence or immunoresistant cold tumor status, can't see the tumor, then it doesn't work on the tumor. As soon as you turn that tumor hot, as soon as you drop the camouflage, boom, you know, it attacks and kills the tumor in many instances. So we're very, very excited about the underlying scientific data that's a part of all these studies, because it helps us to understand it's not just that we see increased survival, but understand exactly why we see increased survival, what the mechanism of action is that is allowing Ampligen to aid in creating therapeutic opportunities for these lethal malignancies.
All right, thanks very much, Tom. Can you just wrap up those thoughts for me?
I think it's important to note all of these cancers that we're working in are major cancers. They're unmet medical needs, but they're large market unmet medical needs. So if we're able to establish our success here, we're able to then create value as a result of that data. This is a data-driven industry. Now, anybody who wants to look at what Ampligen does in oncology can read those papers over the past 60 days, and you'll see why we are moving forward. And 2022 and 2023 are going to be banner years for our company, I believe.
Excellent. All right. Thanks again. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Bye-bye.